Hi, I'm Father Simon Lau. Jesus already ascended into heaven, and his disciples also back in Jerusalem, waiting for the coming of the Holy Spirit. Although some of them still hesitated, which means they may not able to believe that Jesus already resurrected, or they may not understand the plan of God and the mission that Jesus already given to them. Jesus knew what was happened, and Jesus also knows who we are. Just as sometimes in our faithless, we do not trust him enough, but Jesus entrusted us to be his disciples, to bring his good news to others. The first reading told us that Mary, the mother of God, was with the disciples. She was with them praying for the Holy Spirit. When Jesus was crucified on the cross, he entrusted his disciples to his mother. And remember, Mother Mary is praying for us all, even now. Jesus cares for his followers. Even today's gospel is a passage that Jesus prayed for his disciples before he was crucified. And in this Jesus' prayer, we realize that we are at the war field fighting with something we cannot see. We are fighting with the evil force, and we are fighting with the world. And Jesus knew these evil forces will continue to attack his disciples and the church. Therefore, Jesus prayed to the Father, asking for protection for his followers and for those he has given to him, so that we may be one just as the Father and the Son is one. Those who are belong to God is not belong to this world, but yet they have to live in this world, and this is not something easy. Jesus knew all this, so he prayed for us and he prayed for the church. He knew all the challenges that we are facing, and he knew our weakness. He knew our faithless, and also he knew the Holy Spirit will come and strengthen us so that we may one day become perfect in him. To become the disciples of Jesus doesn't mean that we need to become someone special. We do not need to be outstanding. It is not you chose me, but I chose you. The disciples of Jesus, they were not someone very outstanding and very smart. They were fishermen and even sinners. And the smartest one was Judas, the one who betrayed Jesus. The most important thing for following Christ is to be able to respond to his call. Jesus is calling all of us. He is calling each one of us in one way or another, in different time and situation, and in different circumstances. Respond to him, allow him to be the Savior and Redeemer of my life, surrendering ourselves totally into his hand, which means I would not own my life anymore, but he is the owner of my life. And the Holy Spirit will dwell in us and use us fully, because God only uses those who belong to him. However, Jesus also said, many are called, but few are chosen. This doesn't mean that God refused to take some of us, but rather we refuse to respond his call. He is calling all of us. How many people willing to respond and surrender himself for God? Are you willing to surrender yourself for him? Surrender your security and surrender your controlling. Surrender your life into his hand. Very often, we choose self-centeredness, and we choose to remain in bitter and in hatred. We choose not to forgive, we choose not to share. We choose the world and we choose to follow sinful lifestyle and we choose darkness. However, God calls us to love, to forgive, to share. He calls us for justice, for peace, and for mercy. And He calls us to bring His good news to others. When Jesus said, "In them I am glorified," He is telling us that His glory is going to be revealed when His disciples and followers is living the life as what Jesus said, "Love one another as I have loved you." It is because He is no longer in this world, but His body, the church, His followers will continue to be different part of His body in this world. As Saint Teresa of Avila said, "Christ has no body now but yours, no hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which Christ looks compassion into the world. Yours are the feet with which Christ walks to do good. Yours are the hands with which Christ blesses the world." However, as Saint Paul said, we are always following our sinful nature, which desires what contrary to the Holy Spirit. And this is what preventing us from receiving the grace and the power of the Spirit. Today, Jesus is praying for all of us. He is praying for those who are willing to surrender Himself to Him, those who give their life for Him, and He promises us of the Holy Spirit. He wants us to experience the fruit of the Holy Spirit: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And He wants us to have a fruitful life if we allow God to use our life and fill us with His Spirit. He will sanctify us and our lives will become a radiance for others. And just as Moses, after seeing God, came down from Mount Sinai, his face was full of radiance. Likewise, our life also become a reflection of Christ the light. Brothers and sisters, the church was born of the Holy Spirit, and the church is remained and sustained till now because of the Holy Spirit. As what Jesus promised, the Holy Spirit continue to guide and lead the church as the light in the world. And the same Spirit is leading you and I to respond to God's call so that we also glorify Jesus with our life. Amen. Alleluia.